from Nashville, Tennessee, here's the Porter Wagoner Show, starring Porter Wagoner, Dolly Parton, Mel Tillis, Speck Rose, Don Hauser, the Wagon Masters, and today's special guest star. And now, here's Porter.
Oh, the world needs abortion, so I should just think.
Telling you, the world needs a washing. Don, come over here, boy. I'm telling you. We hope you'll enjoy the show today. I think it's going to be a lively one. It started out that way.
Yes, it has, hasn't it?
I want you to introduce this old boy here. He's a regular member of our show, and maybe you can think of something good to say about him.
Boy, let me tell you, I can think of a lot of mighty nice things to say about this one right here. He happens to be one of my favorite singers. And believe you me, you'll enjoy listening right now to Mr. Mel Tillis, ladies and gentlemen.
Billy, fine job,
boss,
man.
Boss, you know something.
What? No.
We what? Better be careful here. Squirrel season's open. Did you know that?
Oh, boy. Mel, we was talking about we've been working so much on the road and doing TV shows and recording. He said, I've got so many songs in my head, I can't remember the words, so we had to write them
That's
down.
That's right. Had to put them
you done
down,
it.
And I still forgot them.
That's a fine job. Well, I'll be right back. Watch this good word. Does fellers down in some of her songs, too. You know it? I'm telling you. You ain't heard it yet. You fixing to hear it right now. Let's make a welcome, Miss Dolly Parton, your handyman.
I have to mow the lawn and I have to wash the car. And I'd just like to know just who you think you are. And I'm getting tired of wagging that old stinking garbage can. Your woman's getting tired of being your old handyman. I have to run your water and I have to wash your back. And I have to scrub the tub.
Thank you. Fine job. I think we ought to write an answer to that. Well, I have to wash the dishes and I have to scrub the floor and I'm getting tired of being your old handy woman. No, that wouldn't work, would it? No, wasn't that awful? What? Yeah. Listen, let's move along. I want you to meet my special guest now, a guy that I admire and respect an awful lot in country music. He's a very good friend of mine and one of the finest artist in the business. Let's make him welcome Roy Boy Drusky. Here he is.
Thank you, Porter. And I don't believe you love me anymore. Lately you've been acting strange to me. Somehow it's not the way it used to be. You're doing things you never dared to do before. And I don't believe you love me anymore. I felt your love grow colder day by day. When I try to hold you close, you turn away. Someone else you're longing for, and I don't believe you love me anymore, anymore. I felt your love grow colder day by day when I tried to hold you close. Someone else. you're longing for. And I don't believe you love me anymore, anymore. No, I don't believe you love me anymore.
Mighty nice, Roy. Thank you. We'll be talking to Roy in just a little while. Fine, fine job. I want to go back now and do one of these songs that I'm kind of proud of, one that sold a good many copies of records. I hope you will enjoy hearing it again.
I got back in town a day before I planned to. I smiled and said I'll sure surprise my wife. I don't think I'll phone, I'll just head on home. 'Cause I didn't know the cold hard facts of life. I passed the little wine store on the corner. I pictured pink champagne by candlelight. I stopped the car right then, got out and hurried in, my mind not on the cold hard facts of life. A stranger stood there laughing by the counter. He said, I'll take two bottles of your best. Her husband's out of town and there's a party. He winked as if to say, you know the rest. I left the store 2 steps behind the stranger. From there to my house, his car stayed inside. But it wasn't till he turned into my drive that I learned I was witnessing the cold hard facts of life. I drove around the block till I was dizzy. Each time the noise came louder from within. And then I saw our bottle there beside me. And I drank a fifth of courage and walked in. Lord, you should have seen their frantic faces. They screamed and cried, please put away that knife. I guess I'll go to hell or I'll rot here in this cell. But who taught who the cold hard facts of life?
Who taught who the cold hard facts of life?
Thank you. We'll be back with the Speck and Dolly and all the Wagon Master in just a few minutes, but watch this. Thank you for watching that good message. I want to get my old buddy here now, Mel Tillis.
Howdy,
Tilly,
Porter.
I look forward to seeing you each week on the show, and we have a package show that we work personal appearances with now, and we want to thank all the folks that come to see Mel, myself, and Dolly, Speck, and all the Wagon Masters.
Right.
And you want to introduce your buddy here?
Yeah, I'd be happy to. Right. Folks, here's one of the world's finer cultivated voices, Speck Rose.
Thank
Hello,
you,
Speck.
Bill.
How you been doing, my
cultivated
boy?
Cultivated voice. I thought maybe you're going to say it'd been plowed under. You know, you I've been talk about plowed under. I've had a lot of fun the last couple of days. Me and Porter have been out playing golf.
Is that right?
Uncle Toby Jug come to town and played with us yesterday.
Yeah.
And Uncle Soak had really been hitting that Mountain Dew, buddy. And we played the first hole. See, we got on the green. Uncle Soak, he was getting pretty high, you see. And he had about a 2-foot putt to make. He took his putter and he reached down and he hit the ball like that and it rolled off to the side. He looked up at Porter. He said, young man, he says, you tilt that green one more time like that and I'll wrap this putter right around your neck. Hey, I'd like to sing a song now entitled Please Help Me, I'm Crawling. Please help me, I'm crawling. She done it again. Slam
slammed the door on my fingers when I tried to get in. She hauled off and kicked out the best tooth I had. I wish she would quit it before I get mad. You told me to go out and find someone new. Anything I wind up with would be better than you. You wanted to leave me, now you're begging to stay. Oh, how can I miss you if you don't go away? Go down to the river where the water is nice. Stick your head under three times and pull it out twice. Go have your face lifted, it needs it no doubt. Go to Peter Pan's beauty shop, for your Pan Peter's out.
That's one that, that's the answer to that song you were talking about.
Oh, boy. Speck, that's fine. He's a dandy. Right now, it comes time on the program that I look forward to each week, as I know many of you folks do that write to us and request the sacred numbers. Here's a song that Miss Dolly wrote herself, and she's going to sing it for you now. A beautiful number titled, He Is Real.
All about me I can see the things His mighty hands have made. The brooks and streams and the peaceful meadows. Trees that fill the earth with shade. Winds that blow from all directions. Some that warm and some that chill. When in doubt, I look around me. And then I know that He is real. He is real. He is real. He is real. He's as real as the sun in the heavens, the moon and stars in the fields of the air. He's as real as the summer roses, for His hands have placed them there. He's as real as the valley and the mountain, the dandelion and the lily of the field. And I am part of His creation, and in my heart I know He's real. I find it hard to understand how one can see and not believe. Everything is for a purpose. God has planned it carefully. Man will look on God's creation, and in their minds they'll doubt Him still. But things so marvelous just don't happen. That's how I know that He is real. He is real. He is real. He is real.
Roy, we're delighted to have you with us, and when we're having a good time, the time seems to fly, and that's what it's done today. But
it does. We've had a lot of fun, though.
Yeah, we got time for a little bit of this, and do us a verse and chorus of it.
Sure will. One of our Mercury records. We hope you like all strangers.
Oh, the love you promised would be mine forever. I would have bet my bottom dollar home. Well, it sure turned out to be a short forever. Just a once I turned my back, you were gone. From now on, all my friends are gonna be strangers. I'm all through never trusting anyone. The only thing I can count on now is my fingers. I was a fool believing in you, and now you are gone.
Thank you.
Thank you, Roy. Right,
thank you.
Great job, man. Always nice to have you. That's every bit of our time. Hope you've enjoyed yourself. If you have, invite us back to your house next week. Till then, so long, Don Boy. See you next week.
This has been the Porter Wagoner Show, a half hour of good country music and fun brought to you from the home of the Grand Ole Opry. This is Don Houser inviting you to tune in next week, same time, same station.